Now let's discuss hash-based approach to message authentication. Using hash values for message authentication has several advantages. For example, hash functions are very efficient to compute, and libraries of hash functions are widely available. On the other hand, a hash function such as SHA cannot be used directly and by itself for message authentication because it does not rely on a secret. There have been a number of proposals to incorporate a secret key into an existing hash function. The approach that has received the most support is HMAC, and it has been adapted to other protocols such as IPsec and TLS. Here's an illustration of how HMAC works. HMAC involves a hash function and also secret key K. The message M consists of multiple blocks of B bits. For example, for SHA-512, each block is 1024 bits, so B would be 1024. So the key K will be first padded to B bits. This is accomplished by simply appending zeros to the end of K. Then the padded key is XORed with IPAD, which is a constant designed to eliminate any regularities of the key. And the result is a B bit S1. S1 is prepended to the original message. Then the entire message, that is S1, and the original message is hashed to produce a n-bit hash value. For example, if the hash function is SHA-512, then n will be 512. Then the n-bit hash value again will be padded to b bits. Then the padded key, k plus, is XOR with OPAD. Again, OPAD is another constant designed to eliminate regularities in the key. The result is a b bit value, S0. The padded hash is then appended to S0, and the entire message is hashed. And the n-bit result is the HMAC of the message with the key K. And this is how HMAC works. To summarize, HMAC uses an existing hash function and includes a secret key, K, in the processing.